sometimes it can feel like we're walking a tightrope between our digital lives and our real lives. If we lean too far toward the real world, we could lose contact with our friends all over the world and miss out on all the news, discussions, and learning opportunities available in cyberspace. But if we lean too far toward the digital world, we'll forget to pay attention to what's happening around us, miss out on in-person experiences, and never meet any of the cool people that live nearby. In this lesson, you'll learn how to add balance between real life and digital life so you can get all the benefits of both without the drawbacks of leaning too far to one side or the other. Woo! Let's get into it. Why do we need to be balanced between our digital and real lives? The problem is, too much time spent in digital life can have some pretty bad consequences. For one thing, the digital world is full of distractions that make it difficult to practice good time management. It's easy to forget that you have schoolwork, chores, and other responsibilities when you're busy playing video games and scrolling through social media. In fact, too much focus on digital friendships using social media can actually damage your social skills. Weird, right? It's because communication online and in real life are very different. If all of your social interactions are through text message, DMs, and social media posts, you can forget how to interpret important parts of in-person interaction, like body language, facial expressions, and vocal tone. Too much digital life can even impact your health. Excessive screen time has been linked to numerous physical and mental health conditions. If you notice that your eyes, neck, or head hurt, or that your emotions are getting all out of whack, it might be time to step away from the screen, at least for a little while. Okay, so too much digital life is bad. Got it. So then the solution is no digital life at all, right? No video games, no social media, no streaming apps, no looking up information on any topic instantly, no Mia Academy? Nope, nuh-uh, can't do it. The non-digital life is not the life for me. In fact, because technology has become so intertwined with modern-day life, it's almost impossible to escape computers and the internet completely. It would require most of us to totally change our lifestyles. Without the internet, you'd lose the ability to easily make friends with people around the world. You'd only be able to make friends with people that live near you, which might make it harder to find people who have similar interests as you. You'd also have limited ways to learn new information without the ability to take online courses, scroll through social media, or look things up on search engines. Instead, you'd have to rely solely on the knowledge of the adults around you and in encyclopedia books that only get revised and republished every 10 years. Oh, talk about old, outdated information. Whew. Plus, life without computers is just a lot less convenient. No texting or DMs, just paper letters that take forever to get to their destination. No ordering things to be delivered to your house. If you want something, you'd have to hope your local store has it in stock when you stop by. Oh, and no GPS, so you'd have to learn how to use a paper map. Ugh, what is this, the 1900s? Ugh. If you want to receive the benefits of modern technology without it harming you, the key is striking a healthy balance between the digital world and the real world. That's easier said than done. But with a few rules and some practice, you can learn how to walk that tightrope with ease. First, set limits for how much screen time you'll have each day. These limits can be as simple as, I will use computers for less than 6 hours a day, or as complex as breaking down your screen time limits for every possible usage. Many operating systems today have built-in settings to help you budget out your screen time limits, including breakdowns of what apps you're using and even timers that lock you out of apps once you've hit your limit. Use your next stint of screen time to explore these settings with a trusted adult. In addition to setting screen time limits, many people find it helpful to intentionally schedule non-digital activities to do as well. For instance, I schedule time to work out at the gym every other day, which gets me away from computer screens for a little while and keeps my body happy and healthy. What you schedule for your non-digital time is totally up to you. If you need help coming up with ideas, think about what you like doing online. Is there a way you could do something similar, but without a computer? If you like reading ebooks, read a physical book when your screen time is over. If you like chatting with friends online, why not schedule some time to hang out in person? Whatever you like doing online, there's probably a non-digital way of doing the same thing. Next, be aware of what's going on around you and recognize if you are in an unplugged situation. For instance, many families have a no screens policy at mealtime so that everyone savors the food and engages in conversation with one another. Or if you're adventuring out in nature, put your phone away and appreciate the beauty of the world around you. But part of recognizing unplugged situations is knowing when it's acceptable to plug back in, even if it's just for a moment. If someone likes your food and asks for your recipe, you can quickly text them the link. Or if you witness something breathtaking in the wild, snap a pic to look back on later. Just don't forget to unplug again afterward. The key is knowing when it's acceptable to be plugged in and when you should unplug and live in the real world for a bit. Finally, stay mindful of your own health, both physical and mental. If you notice that your neck is starting to hurt, or you can feel a headache coming on, or whatever's on your computer is making you angry or sad, take a break from the computer. These can all be signs that your balance is starting to tilt too far into the digital world. So break yourself out of it and get in touch with the real world for a little bit. Remember, nobody's perfect. It's hard to keep a perfect balance on the tightrope between real and virtual. We all lose our balance sometimes, and end up leaning too far into the digital world. The important thing is that you recognize when this happens and hop right back on the tightrope as soon as possible. Now that you know how to keep your digital life and real life balanced, you're on your way to becoming a full-fledged citizen of the digital world. But part of being a digital citizen is recognizing that all of the information you put online and everything you do in digital spaces creates data that acts like a trail of footprints leading right back to you. In the next lesson, you'll learn how to manage your digital footprint so that you don't regret what data gets publicly linked to you for the rest of your life. Until then, remember, your brain is the smartest computer you'll ever have, so keep it charged and never stop updating it. See you next time! Hey, hey.